Hello, welcome back to the 86th Street Performing Arts Center. Yulika and I are back with another hymn. This is also one that will be very familiar to you, I'm sure. Before I tell you what it is, I'm going to tell you a little bit about it, and maybe you'll be able to figure out what it is before I tell you. This hymn was written by, the words were written by an Anglican minister. This gentleman, let's see, I'm looking at my notes here. His name was John Newton. And he used to be a slave trader. He started out as a slave trader. But during a really big, bad storm, he cried out to God for mercy, and God gave him that mercy. He was spared from that storm, and long story short, he became an Anglican minister and an abolitionist. I know, that's a very condensed version of this story, but he did become a minister and an abolitionist, and he wrote the words to this hymn, and these words were sung to several different melodies, and then the words made their way to the United States, and it was put to one particular melody, and this melody is what this song is known by maybe around the world. It's a very common, I don't know if is common the right word. It's a popular hymn. Maybe that's a better word. It's a very popular hymn in the United States. It's very well known. It is sung for religious purposes and for secular purposes. It's been recorded umpteen times by sacred and secular performers. Do you know what it is? I'll tell you. It's Amazing Grace. Performing Arts Center. If you like what you're hearing, please subscribe, and that way you'll be notified anytime I upload a new video. And I hope you join me next time when I bring you one last hymn for April. All right, thanks. Bye.